Hello and welcome to my stream. Today I shall be playing Audio Surf 2 for you, as is my custom. Just give me 1 second to make sure my audio is working. And it's working. Okay. I haven't streamed in a little while because the last time I did, I was having some major issues, but I'm back and hopefully they're all solved. This stream is basically the exact same one that I tried to do a month ago, but I'll explain it again because hopefully no one saw that. I have been recently going through old files on my computer, and I happened to come across a folder that had a couple of mixes that I made for an ex of mine. And I decided that it would be very interesting to go through them all on the stream. Maybe discuss each one and why maybe they mean something. Who knows? So, without any further ado, let's get into it. The first song that is up is the Drums with their song Book of Revelation. Now, the Drums are a band that I used to be majorly in love with, and now I couldn't really care about too much. Not that they're bad, I have no real connection with them anymore. But this song and the album this song is off of was one that me and my ex would listen to a lot, so that's why I put this on here. And I'd say it's still a good song, regardless of the fact that I don't really listen to them as much anymore, but... yeah, well, let's see what you think. This is Book of Revelation by the Drums.
Oh,
And that was The Drums with Book of Revelation. And moving along to the next song, this is Real Estate with Easy. So this song is a song that from another band that, again, I loved in college, loved years and years ago, but nowadays don't really care about too much. Again, don't dislike them. Don't think they're a bad band. I've moved on. Again, that said, this song is still, I think, really, really good. I still would consider the song to be one of the better songs I've ever heard. So that's saying something. And because of that, I'd say that anyone would enjoy it. I had a friend in college who really wasn't super musically inclined. Like, they didn't listen to a lot of very various stuff. Really only what, like, they heard when they were younger, with barely any sort of deviation from that. So when I played him this, he fell in love with it, and I think that Real Estate is still his favorite band to this day. So, yeah. Shouts out Nick if you're out there. So, yeah, let's just get to it. This is Easy by Real Estate.
Thank you.
And that was Easy by Real Estate. All right, and coming up next is Fonts with Feel Love Thinking Of. This is a band that, or maybe even just a solo artist, actually, I don't really know, that I don't know super well. I've only ever listened to the name, or the album that the song is, or that is named after this song. And the album's pretty good, I really enjoy it. But, again, I don't really know much about them other than that. And this is a song that I really like a lot still, even today. And, again, I think this is just a feel-good song that anyone can enjoy, so that's really the only explanation that is really needed as to why it was on my mix. I think we just both really liked it. So, yeah, let's just keep going. This is Fonts with Feel Love Thinking Of. Fonts with Feel Love Thinking Of. And coming up next is Rye and their song Open. Now Rye is a duo, with one being the producer slash musician of the group and one just being the vocalist. It surprised a lot of people to know that the lead singer for this duo is a man, because their voice is very feminine and very soulful, so it's surprising to many people who find that out. I love this song. And I hope you guys do as well. This is Rye with Open.
shaking your thumb. I'm a fool for that sound in your slums. I'm a fool for your belly. I'm a fool for your love. I wanna make this play. Oh, I know you're faded. But stay. Pool held in your arms, caught like a fool without alarm. We're in a natural spring with this gentle sting between us. I wanna make this play. Oh, I know you're faded. But stay.
Was Rye with Open. Okay, and coming up next is the Radio Department with Heavens on Fire. Now, I love the Radio Department, as I've said many, many times on this stream, but this isn't one of my favorite songs of theirs. It's a good song, I enjoy it, but I wouldn't classify this even in my top 10, probably, of songs of theirs that I like. But that said, all of my friends in college, including my ex, loved this one. So that's why I included this song over a lot of the others that I could have included. I understand why. It's a good song, a very poppy. It was their single, I think, for when this album was released. So it makes sense. So yeah, let's listen to it. This is The Radio Department with Heavens on Fire.
People see rock and roll as youth culture, and when youth culture becomes monopolized by big business, what are the youth to do? Do you have any idea? I think we should destroy the bogus capitalist process that is destroying youth culture.
Thank you.
The radio department with Heavens on Fire. And coming up next is Dive with Past Lives. Now, I've seen Dive live back when they first released this album, and they were very good. I liked them a lot. This is yet another band, if you can believe it, that I used to like a hell of a lot when I was in college, and then just sort of fell off of eventually. This is a very good song, though, and again, like the rest of the songs that have been on here so far, is on here because it's just kind of a happy, peppy song that I think anyone can enjoy. So let's give it a nice little listen. This is Dive with Past Lives. Dive with Past Lives. God damn, it is really hot in my room right now. I cannot wait for my apartment building to switch from the heat to the AC, because it's very sorely needed. Coming up next is Mew with the song Hawaii, which is one of their best songs, in my opinion. It's really good, and Mew, as I've mentioned millions of times, is my favorite band of all time. And this song is my favorite song off of my favorite album of theirs. Actually, that's hard to say. It's one of my favorite songs. It's a tie between this and two others. So it's one of them. It's one of the best songs on the album, though, for sure. Do you like it? Let's find out. This is Mew with Hawaii. Thank you. that was Mew with their song Hawaii. And coming up next, I guess I should wait, but now coming up next is Twin Shadow with I Can't Wait. Speaking of waiting, can you believe it? What a coincidence. I have spoken on this before. Twin Shadow is an artist that I really, really loved when I was in college. But he changed pretty heavily in terms of what kind of music he made, like, pretty soon after his first album. And I hated the direction he went in, and so I just never really cared to listen to him again. And from what I can tell, he keeps going in that trajectory, so I made the right choice. But I think I've played this song on my stream before, so I don't really need to introduce it again too much, so I guess I'll just go into it. This is Twin Shadow with I Can't Wait. Shadow with I Can't Wait. That song, gives me a lot of flashbacks, a lot of good memories of just like walking during in college in the summer, just getting like a milkshake or something. I don't know. It gives me that feeling again. I don't even think I listened to the song that much during the summer, but that's the feeling I get when I listen to it again. Coming up next, ooh, this is an interesting one. This is Deer Hunter with Revival. Now, Deer Hunter, now, believe it or not, is another band that I loved in college that I don't care for as much today. Love this album, though, still. I think this album that is fantastic, but the rest of their stuff I don't listen to as much. Maybe I should. I don't know. Maybe I should. They have some really good stuff. This is a short and sweet one, but my girlfriend really liked this song, which is funny because I don't think she ever paid attention to the lyrics, because my girlfriend was very, or ex-girlfriend was very, very afraid of death, believe it or not. I know, weird, right? But she couldn't even think about it, like, without going to panic attacks. And this song is about how, like, dying sucks, but there's no way that there can be nothing, right? Like, I think that the lead singer is pretty religious, and he's like, there's no way there's nothing after death, right? That's what the song is about, I'm pretty sure. So, her loving the song and not really paying attention to the lyrics is very ironic to me. How about you pay attention to the lyrics right now? This is Deer Hunter with Revival. Was Deer Hunter with Revival. Did you like it? I hope so. Coming up next is Little Dragon with Shuffle a Dream. Now, I've definitely played this song on the stream before, but I would be remiss to not include this in this list. This was a favorite of all of my friends when I first played it. They would ask me to play this song almost every day at a certain point. They were in love with it, and I can see why. It's a good song. Little Dragon in general, I have never been that much a fan of, but this song I have always loved, so hopefully you will too. This is Little Dragon with Shuffle a Dream.
You cruise around and you deal lots of watercraft. Play big and design a shades up to my class. And the girl
Shuffle a Dream by Little Dragon. Alright, and coming up next is LSD and the Search for God with Starting Over. This is a band... Actually, let me clarify something real quick. I've realized I've been saying a lot of time my friend group, my friends, when referring to stuff in college and my ex. I should clarify that my ex and I... We're in the same friend group for about a year in college before we started dating. So when I refer to my friend group, I usually mean, like, that time before we were dating, but we were still, like, we still knew each other, so that the reference of these songs still applied when we were dating. So which is why I would include things from when we weren't dating, because still good songs that we both enjoyed. But this is a song that I don't really think she gave a shit about, but I wanted to pad out... the mix, and so I included just a song that I liked, and I still like to this day. LSD and the Search for God is a very good shoegaze band, and I like them a lot. So let's give them a listen. This is LSD and the Search for God with Starting Over.
Thank you.
And that was Starting Over by LSD and The Search for God. All right, and coming up next is Destroyer with Suicide Demo for Kara Walker. So Destroyer is one of the singers, one of the many singers from the New Pornographers, and he has a voice that I find really soothing and I really enjoy. That said, this is another song that I used to pad out the mixtape, if I'm remembering correctly, because I don't think she gave a shit about this guy at all. But I love the song a lot. I still listen to Destroyer frequently enough, especially this album. So let's give it a listen. This is Destroyer with Suicide Demo for Kara Walker.
Proud American. slide away. Harmless little negress, you got to say yes to another excess. Let's go for a ride today. In possession of eyes that sit. In possession of eyes that sit. A southern bunkhouse, blue skies up above. Figure feminine, grace and wit passes for love these days. All that slender-wristed, white, translucent business passes for love these days. Mesh head, genius passes for love these days. For more years. For of this shit, fuck it. I look up, I see the North Star. I look up, I see the North Star. When I look up at the bar through these tears, fall like pillars, Yankee style. All of America loves to light its pipes. All of America live to light his pipe at night. To which Dixie responds, free.
And that was Destroyer with Suicide Demo for Kara Walker. I'm looking at my stream, and while thankfully it's not choppy, my webcam looks like doo-doo. At least during that song it did. Weird. Anyway, coming up next is Wild Nothing with Through the Grass. I've said this before, Wild Nothing is great. I mentioned that I saw Dive in concert previously on the stream a few songs ago. They were opening for Wild Nothing. And I met them. I met both Dive and Wild Nothing, and they're both very cool. And this song is not my favorite song of his, but it's a very good song of his. And it's one that I don't think I've played on the stream before, which is a mistake. It's great. let's fix that mistake right now. This is Wild Nothing with Through the Grass. That was Through the Grass by Wild Nothing. And coming up next is Interpol with Pace is the Trick. This is a song that I think I've played a few times before, so it's kind of not too happy that I'm playing it again, but the theme of the stream is every song on the mixtape I made. So, Here we go. No need to even intro this. It's just, I've introed it enough already on the stream before. So here we go. Interpol with Pace is the Trick.
You can't hold it too tight. These matters of security. You don't have to be wound so tight. Smoking on the balcony. But it's like sleaze in the park. You women, you have no self-control. The angels remark outside. We're known for insatiable needs. I don't know a thing. I've seen
Interpol with Pace is the Trick. Okay, coming up next is The National with Lemon World, and we've now exited that string of songs that I put on this on the mix for her, just to sort of pad it out, and now we're back to songs that she actually liked. This was my favorite song on this album. It still is, but that means I would play this song a lot, and then she also got to know it. It's a bit of a sadder song than most of the other songs that I've put on this playlist, but who cares? You know, fuck you if you're sad. That's my take. That's my opinion. Sad bitch. This is The National with Lemon World.
I was invited. Give me a reason to get out of the city. See you inside, watching swans on TV. Living and dying in New York, it means nothing to me. I gave my heart to the army. The only sentimental thing I could think of. Cousins and cousins somewhere overseas. But it'll take a better war to kill a college man like me. I'm too tired to drive anywhere, anyway right now. Do you care if I stay? You can put on your bathing suits and I'll try to find something on this thing that means nothing enough. Losing my breath. Losing my breath. Sister live in a lemon world. I wanna sit in and die. You and your sister live in a lemon world. You and your sister live in a lemon world. I wanna sit in and die. You and your sister live in a lemon world. This pricey stuff makes me dizzy. I guess I've always been a delicate man. It takes me a day to remember a day. I didn't mean to let it get so far out of hand. I was a comfortable kid, but I don't think about it much anymore. Lay me on the table, put flowers in my mouth, and we can say that we invented a summer love and torture party. I'm too tired to drive anywhere, anyway, right now. Do you care if I stay? You can put on your bathing suits and I'll try to find something on this thing that means nothing enough. You and your sister live in a lemon world. I wanna sit in and die. Sister live in a lemon world. You and your sister live in a lemon world. I wanna sit in and die. You and your sister live in a lemon world. Losing my breath.
And that was The National with Lemon World. I really love that song. It still makes me a little bit emotional listening to it. I think it's great. And coming up next is Future Islands with Balance. Now, Future Islands is a band that happened a little bit after college, but I was in love with them during college and, again, fell out of love with them eventually. They just started releasing music that I didn't connect with as much as I used to. And honestly, it started with this album. This whole album isn't my favorite of theirs, but it still has some really good songs, including this one. And it's also probably the most accessible album of the three that I enjoy of theirs, so that's why I think this song connected with my friends so much when I first played it for them. Let's give this one a shot. This is Future Islands with Balance.
Yeah.
That was Future Islands with a Balance. What's up, Tiny Jars? Welcome. Glad you could drop by. Oh, I'm looking over at my webcam during the song, and boy, does it look awful. I just realized that I never fixed my bitrate from when I tried to lower it before. Oh, it looks bad, but now it looks fine, so can't complain too much. Coming up next, this is the last song on the first mix that I made, believe it or not. I guess I should let you know what I'm doing here, Tiny Jars, since you're watching now. This is the stream. I a few weeks ago, I found some files on an old hard drive of mixes that I created for an ex. I decided that would be an interesting thing to do, where I just play all the songs from those two mixtapes and then talk about them on here. I think that'd be cool. So far, it's been all right. I don't understand bitrate, if that helps. Neither do I. Not really, but I do know that higher bitrate means better quality video, and lower bitrate means lower quality video. But it also higher bitrate also means more strain on your computer, and lower bitrate means less strain. So that's why I lowered it before. But now it's looks like shit. So by the next stream, it'll be better. I'll put it back to what it was. Well, that's interesting. Thank you very much for saying that. I like the idea a lot. It's very interesting. A lot of these bands that I've listened to so far are bands that I don't listen to anymore, which is surprising. There's songs I still all like. I like all these songs. Like, I like all the bands still technically, but I just haven't followed up with them at all in the past, like, 5 or 6 years for whatever reason. Maybe even more. How old am I now? 28? I graduated in college in 2014, because, like, essentially I stopped all the bands here that I stopped listening to, that I don't listen to still, I stopped listening to essentially during my senior year of college, or right after my senior year of college, which was 2014. But that said, this band, Fleet Foxes, is not one of those bands. I still love them. I still love this song. They're one of my favorite bands of all time. And like I said, this is the last song on this specific mix that I made. I made two mixes. The first mix was filled with songs that we liked when... So I basically would play a lot of songs to my friend group that she was a part of before we were dating. And that mix was full of a lot of those songs. And this is one of them. This has always been, ever since it got released, one of my favorite songs of all time. And I made that known even in college. And it grew on her and all of my friends that I played it to. Hopefully you enjoy it as well. This is Fleet Foxes with Blue Ridge Mountains.
I'm sure it'll be fine.
And that was Fleet Foxes with Blue Ridge Mountains. The part right before the climax where he goes, "I love you, oh brother of mine," is one of my favorite moments of any song ever, for a very personal reason. This song and this band was introduced to me by my brother, Naveed, back when I was in, like, 10th grade. And I credit him for basically my music taste today. Like, even though once I think around 2011, or 2010, 2011, I really started exploring out on my own and figuring out my own taste from there. Everything up until that point, I really found because of him. And so I hear that song, I hear that moment, and I always think of him. I love my brother very much. It's a little side note from everything else going on in the stream. That's cute. I think I've received more mixtapes than I ever made. I still have a CD around somewhere that an XGF made me when we were teens. Most likely Rilo Kiley. I think I've received one mixtape from an ex-girlfriend of mine, and that was when I was in high school. And she made me a mixtape full of stuff that I absolutely despised. I hated all of it. And it was awful. Just not a good mixtape for me personally. And I gave her one. And in my mind, I was like, yo, this mixtape fucking rules. I'm so good at mixtapes. I'm so smart. My music taste is great. And I can only imagine looking back that she thought the exact same thing about my mixtape that I thought about hers. We were so two very different people. Our music tastes were a perfect example of that, just not even close to being the same. Like, she sent me, like, a lot of, I don't even remember, like, whatever was popular in, like, 2009, 2008, whatever pop music was popular back then, like, Taylor Swift, like, old Taylor Swift, and a lot of shit like that, and I didn't like it. And I would give her, like, Radiohead and TV on the Radio and Muse and My Morning Jacket and Sigur Rós, all shit that, like, yeah, I like and is good, but, I mean, I didn't account for her tastes at all. Like, the National, shit like that. Like, and I was like, I was just a little shitter back then. But yeah. Nice to revisit things, I agree. If I could find the CD I made her, that would be amazing. I don't think I ever could. I don't think she'd ever get back to me. I had a copy of it for myself or anything. That said, if I found the CD she made me, that would be interesting. I'm going to see if I can find that when I go home next time. I think it's back in my parents' house in my old room. Oh, that's so nice. Yeah, I mean, I love my brother. Shouts out, Naveed, wherever you might be. Yeah, it's a lot of this shit is fun to think about, honestly. A lot of old but gold memories, honestly. And this is the beginning of the second mixtape I made for my ex. And this was a song that I put on here because we had just watched, what the fuck is it called? The movie with Bill Murray, Lost in Translation. And this song is on there. And she made a note of saying that she enjoyed this song. And I was like, well, I know what I'm putting on the mix. And so it was this one. It's the Jesus and Mary Chain with Just Like Honey. I owe my older brothers a lot of, like, getting into video games. Yeah, yeah, it's really interesting when you have a relationship with your siblings, how much, especially when they're older, how much they influence what you do. Because when you're younger, all you want to do is, like, have your siblings' approval. You want your siblings to like you for whatever reason. Like, I love my brother. I've always loved my brother. Like, we've never had a problem. Like, he is my best friend. Like, I don't feel weird saying that. I love and adore my brother so much. But when I was a little kid, like, I had no real reason to want his approval so much other than that he was just my big brother. So I think that's similar for a lot of people. Unless you have an awful relationship with them where they're abusive and bullying to you, I can imagine that most people have the thoughts that I did. And so, yeah, what they like, you end up liking. Oh, shit, Lost Relation was a huge for me as a teen. Yes, I still love a lot of what I got from that soundtrack. I still love to this day, I should say. There's stuff on there that I didn't really give a shit about, but what I've heard, I still enjoy. Or what I heard that I enjoyed then, I still enjoy now, is what I mean. I'm getting a lot of mumble mouth, I'm talking too much, let's just get into it. This is Jesus and the Mary Chain with Just Like Honey.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the Jesus and Mary Chain with Just Like Honey. I saw them live a couple years ago, opening for Nine Inch Nails. They were fantastic, and honestly, Nine Inch Nails was too. I don't really like Nine Inch Nails very much, but that show was amazing, and it was very cool seeing the Jesus and Mary Chain live as well. I had a poster for the movie on my wall as a baby. Don't know if I'd be so keen on it now, but a lot of tunes on the soundtrack still go, like Air and My Bloody Valentine. Those were the two, along with the Jesus and Mary Chain that I was referring to when I mentioned that the ones that I loved from the soundtrack I still love today. Like, Air and My Bloody Valentine are still staples for me in my rotation of bands I listen to. I feel like I'd probably still like the movie. I think it has a good melancholic feel to it that is universal and more timeless than you might expect. That's it. I mean, I haven't watched it in a while, so maybe I'm just talking out of my ass, but I feel like if I watch it again, I'd enjoy it. Maybe not as much. It might not. If I watch it for the first time now, I don't think it'd be as influential as it was to me when I was younger, but I still think I'd enjoy it, you know? Who knows? I could be wrong, though. I could be full of shit. Kind of next is Deer Hunter with Agoraphobia. Now, this one, because I played Deer Hunter earlier on the last mixtape, and she liked that song so much, I decided to pop this one on here, because this is another song by them that I really like. And I don't think she cared for this one as much when she listened to it. I don't think this was her favorite, but I don't think she hated it. But yeah, I feel like this one was more of a swing and a miss than anything else. I like the song, though, so we're playing it today. We're not dating anymore. So I can play the song anytime I goddamn want to now. So yeah, let's listen to it. This is Deer Hunter with Agoraphobia. And that was Deer Hunter with Agoraphobia. Hope you liked it. Right, same. I think Lost in Translation hit me at the right time, and I was, like, as a teen, like, whoa, cinema. Yeah, I get that. That's definitely a movie that, when you're a teenager, you cite as, like, one of your favorites because you want to seem like you're smarter. That you like movies, I guess, that you show that you're, like, a cool movie guy. Nothing wrong with that, but that is what that movie is, for sure. Well, coming up next, it is Grizzly Bear with 2 Weeks. I love this song. I think most people like this song that have heard it. It's a good song. Not really any more explanation other than that as to why it's on here. I think we just separately both enjoyed this song, and so I put it on here. So yeah. Let's go. Let's listen to it. This is Grizzly Bear with 2 Weeks.
Oh.
Grizzly Bear with 2 weeks. Fuck, I loved Grizzly Bear tune. I'm delighted because I haven't heard this in forever. What a song. Yeah, Grizzly Bear is great. I don't think they've released an album since 2017, but everything that they've released in the past, I guess, decade, I've loved so much. They are so good. I need to look up to see if they've come out with a new album at all recently, because Pain and Ruins was good, their latest, but it wasn't their best. Yeah, I haven't had one since 2017. That's a goddamn shame. I miss them. I really miss them a lot. How you been keeping, by the way? I haven't been able to stop by a stream in ages. Welcome back. I've been fine. I actually, it's not really all on you. I took about a month or 28-day break, is what it said when I last streamed. I did a stream on Monday, but before that, I hadn't streamed in about 3.5 weeks, I think. So, it's been a little while. But yeah, I've been fine. I've been just enjoying myself, playing games. I got my second COVID vaccine shot in, I'd say, four or five days. It'll have been the full 2 weeks where I got the second shot. So I'll be done and I'll be safe. Whoopsie-daisy, that's my ringtone for my text. Don't listen to it. It feels good. It feels good. Still a bit bummed that, you know, everything is lonely in my apartment by myself, but I'm keeping on trying to go on dating apps and stuff, and meet new people. And that's honestly been going better than it has been, because I've noticed now that I have fully vaccinated on my dating profiles, suspiciously getting more matches, if you can believe it. In fact, speaking of which, I just got a message from Tinder right now. Wow. But yeah, I can't wait to feel more comfortable going out. Like, I was going out to get grocery stores and stuff like that anyway, but once the 2 weeks are up, I'm going to start going to restaurants and maybe go to more public places, like a park or a museum or anything like that, where, you know, because why not? I might go back into work a bit more often than I was before. It's going to be nice. It's going to be very nice. How about you? Vaccinated is the new attractive trait. That's true. That said, in about a month, the uniqueness of that trait will be gone, which on a global scale I'm happy about, but on a romantic scale I'm fucked. But yeah, how about you? Have you been busy in a good way? Have you been busy in a bad way? Or have you just been not feeling streams? How, like, what is going on in your life that is taking you away from me? No, how have you been? I really want to know. A few months on vaccine here, I think, damn, that fucking sucks. I forget that globally the vaccination rate is different. Like, each country has a different way of that they're doing it. That sucks. I hope that you get it sooner than that. I really do. Coming up next is Wild Beasts with All the King's Men. And I love this song and this band. This is a band that I have also fallen off of because I think a few... But this is way after college, though. A few years ago, they started making songs that I wasn't really feeling, and so I dropped them. But this album is a perfect mix of their brand of music. Their first album is super, like, pop-punky, really weird. Their third album is kind of slow, more thought-provoking, more introspective is the word I'm thinking of. It feels more mature. And this album is a perfect combo of the two. And so I listened to this song and this band and this album a lot when I was in college, and so it kind of bled through to my friends, my ex-girlfriend, and so that's why it's on here. It's also, I'd say, the song is probably one of the least weird on the album as a whole. So I think that also helps as to why I added this on the mixtape, because it's not... The lead singer has a very unique voice, and he's not the lead singer on this track. It's the backup singer who is featured prominently on this one. I've been good, just busy working, which isn't so bad, really, but very boring. Ireland has been super locked down, so I'm excited for, like, just getting to do anything. I feel that completely. Ah, yes, tune. Fuck yes. That's not to delay this any longer. This is Wild Beasts with All the King's Men. Wild Beasts with All the King's Men. Can you believe it? But yeah, I love that song. And I love that album to death. It's very good. Coming up next is Radiohead with High and Dry. Now, I love Radiohead. I think they're a great band. Not a really controversial opinion, I think. Pretty sure that that's the opinion of many people around the planet. But for some reason or another, this is the only song that my ex liked from Radiohead, so I had to include it on here. She just never gelled with them. Can't explain why, because they're damn good. But, yeah, this is the only song she ever liked, so I had to throw in Radiohead in the mix somewhere, so I'm glad I could throw in this song. So, yeah, let's listen to it. This is Radiohead. I don't know why I said it like that. This is Radiohead with High and Dry.
Still make love.
Radiohead with High and or Dry. Tiny Rush says, oh, I missed the era of mixtapes. I guess making, like, Spotify playlists is a thing now, but it doesn't feel the same. Yeah, I'm one of the last holdouts, people who just doesn't use Spotify for whatever reason. It never clicked with me. I remember when I was in college, this girl that sat next to me in one of my, like, English classes was tell me about Spotify and how I always brought my iPod pod with me. I was always wearing my headphones. And so I guess she knew I was a big music fan. She's like, there's this thing called Spotify that's out right now. You should try it out. It's like Pandora, but you get to choose the music you like. They have so much stuff on there. I'm like, okay, interesting. I guess I'll try it out. And then I just never did. And then also, side note, pretty sure she liked me. And looking back, I feel really dumb. Because I thought she was a cool person, and I would have at least liked to have gone on a date with her. That would have been great. But I'm dumb. I never noticed it till later. But anyway, I like to have my own physical media. I don't want to have to download it off of Spotify. Like you're saying, I use Bandcamp whenever I can. I'll try to buy stuff from Bandcamp whenever I can. Like all of the music I have is saved to saved to my computer, like as an MP4. It used to be for me that Spotify used to not have a lot of stuff on it. It was very limited in terms of music that I liked. But from what I can tell, that doesn't really seem to be an excuse anymore. But yeah, I just don't want to use Spotify. I really enjoy having my own music collection and sticking to that. But yeah, thank you for supporting me in that decision, by the way. I appreciate that. A lot of people don't really seem to understand it, but they can all go fuck themselves. But I feel like one day I'm going to have to. My laptop just recently broke about a month ago, and having to transfer files from my hard drive, which I won't get into the specifics, but it was all fucked up, and I had to do this whole, like, super roundabout way to get files from the hard drive onto my laptop. It wasn't a fun experience, and I don't know if I want to go through that again. So I feel like eventually my collection will be something that isn't a thing anymore, which is unfortunate. That's what happens with any sort of digital media, is that eventually it'll go away, just because something's going to fail, something's going to get corrupted, and if you don't have backups in 7 different locations, it's going to be forever borked, and I feel like that's going to happen eventually. Theo, what is up? These are the thoughts come out while listening to early Radiohead regrets from years past. That is, yeah, hard to notice at the time. Very true. I still find it a bit shit when I try to look up international bands and stuff. They're just not on Spotify. That's a big thing. A lot of Japanese bands, for example, that I enjoy aren't on there, because I feel like Japanese music as a whole really hasn't evolved past, like, CDs. Like, they're still, like, Japan is, like, the last bastion of physical media for music, which is insane. Like, I hear all the time that if your CD does well in Japan, then you did really good. Like, you have really good sales. Which is why so many bands, little-known fact for maybe someone else out there, you guys might know this, but little-known fact, that's why they have Japanese bonus tracks in so many albums, because they want the goddamn CD to sell well in Japan. But yeah, it's. I don't know. I just, it's not for me. My brother, my parents use Spotify. I'm too cool for it, dudes. Bandcamp is still holding out as a relatively artist-empowering online distribution of copies. Yes, Bandcamp I love. I do love Bandcamp because it seems to be very much, like you said, for the artist. And if the artist wants to have them, wants to host the song for free on Bandcamp and have it so that you can listen to it digitally for free as much as you want, then you can. If you want it so that you have to pay for it, you can. Like, it's their choice, and I respect that. Bandcamp Friday is actually a relatively big deal for musicians. Lets us take bigger cuts of merchandise. Yeah, I've heard about that. I remember Randy did that with his big collection for the Black Lives Matter protests and stuff when he wanted to donate to the lockout charities. He made sure to release it on Friday so that he could get more proceeds for the compilation and then donate all those proceeds towards the charities, which I thought was smart. But yeah, coming up next is The Pains of Being Pure at Heart with Young Adult Friction. Now, I don't want to get in too much specifics, but this was a song. I love the song even before I started going out with this girl, but this is a song that she liked a lot, and we would listen to. Again, no specifics here. This isn't a filthy stream, but this is a song that we would listen to a lot when we would have sex. I know, I'm sorry. I let the cat out of the bag. I fuck. And so I don't really associate this with that, but whenever I think of that time and this song comes up, I remember that, if that makes sense. This is a good fucking song. Theo is going off saying we're sad tonight. Tiny Jars also loves the song. Good. I love Pains of Being Pure at Heart. They haven't been as good in the past couple releases, I feel like. Their last, I forget the name of the album, but the last good release of theirs was the one after this. The one after that was fine, and the one after that was okay. I hope that they keep releasing music, though, and I hope they go back to their former style, because I'm not the biggest fan of what they are now. As I've said, I guess, three times, repeating myself. I'm talking too much. That's enough of that. Let's listen to the song. This is Pains of Being Pure at Heart with Young Adult Friction. And that was The Pains of Being Pure at Heart with Young Adult Friction. Alrighty, moving right along to the next song. This is Headless Horseman by The Microphones. Now, this is one that I just kind of threw in here as filler for when I wanted to make this mixtape. I don't think she ever really connected with this album, like, at all. I don't think she liked this album very much, but I did. So I had to throw one of these songs in there, and this is, in my opinion, the most, I don't want to say normal, but I'm going to say it, the most normal song on this album. The most accessible one, I guess, is a better word for it. It's definitely the most mixtapeable one, in my opinion, because there's no way I was going to, like, do fade-ins and fade-outs and pick and choose, like, which songs matched which, like, came after. But I felt the song was a good just, it fits anywhere on a mixtape song, so I picked this one off this album. Oh shit, this album was, like, I'm gonna guess, a big deal for me. Hell yes. Yeah, this album fucking rules. I have the vinyl of it on my shelf, and it pisses me off, because leave it to this fucking guy, fucking The Microphones Mount Eerie bitch, to make the most, like, uncomfortable, awkward packaging. You know what? I'm gonna show it off. I hate it. It's a great record, but fuck him for making it this way. God damn, I hate it. It's like, I cannot wait for my plastic sleeves to get in here, to arrive. It's like this? Hold on, where is my, there it is, here it is. So, it's like this, but I guess the album is really like this, and then you have to, it's like, it folds in, like there's no slot for you to insert it into the thing. It's just like, I don't know, really uncomfortable and really inconvenient, and there's two of them, and so, there's two, it's a double vinyl, it sucks, but hey, the album's good. It's also a pain in the ass to put it in and out of the shelf, so I kind of regret doing that. Okay, here we go. It's back. Alright, that's enough of that. I've talked enough about this great album, so let's listen to it, shall we? This is The Microphones with Headless Horseman.
Straight up.
And that was The Microphones with Headless Horseman. I'm not gonna lie, I kind of love how confusing the packaging is. Fuck you! No, it's very, it's funny, it's just interesting. I do like it. I just wish that it wasn't so flimsy, and I'm always afraid of handling it, because if I drop the vinyls, then that's a bad thing. Coming up next is Foals with Olympic Airways. So this is back in the time before I got super into Total Life Forever. I was all into Antidotes when this album first even came out, so I would listen to this all the fucking time. But now for me, Total Life Forever is my favorite of theirs. So this song is a banger, and I had to include it on the playlist because she also really enjoyed it. This is another song that actually my girlfriend before her also liked, now that I think about it. Foals is just damn good. So, I mean, you can't really blame him for liking it. Theo says, Antidotes is 1,000,000% full of certified bangers. Yeah, yep, you guys are both feeling it, and I don't want to keep you waiting, you know? Because, yeah, it's a good fucking album. Foals rules. Hopefully I can get this on vinyl soon, because I love this album very much. Let's hop into it. This is Foals with Olympic Airwaves, baby!
Thank you.
And that was Foles with Olympic Airways. Hope you guys liked it, because it's a damn good tune. Theo says, Tiny Dars first says, I remember seeing them live just after the release. I saw them live, I almost saw them live after this release, and I missed it, and I was pissed at myself. I really wanted to see them. I was like, they're never going to come back. And then they came back for Total Life Forever, and I saw that show, and it fucking ruled. They rule, and I love them. And then I saw them again, I think, in early 2019, I think, is when I saw them again. And both shows, the first show I saw was in a much smaller venue than the second show, but they were both really, really good in their own way. Like, they are in a fantastic live band. I love them. Theo says, God, I miss Walter, the Earl bassist from Pre-Antidotes up until what went down. Yannis and Jimmy syncopated guitars was a big part of my musical education, though. So good. Yeah, the bass in their earlier albums is phenomenal. Like, I didn't know that their bassist left. That explains a lot, actually. But yeah, the guitars, especially on that song during that big the big climax, to me is, it's just perfect. It's perfect. Okay, coming up next is Cursive with The Recluse. Cursive is a band that I've loved since I was in like 7th or 8th grade. I love Cursive to death, especially The Ugly Organ. This is an album this is a seminal album in my life, I think. Just everything about it is incredible to me, and this is, I think, the best song on the album. And again, I don't think my ex liked Cursive very much, but I did, so I shoved it on the goddamn mixtape I made her. I remember going to see Cursive live in college when I was dating her, and playing, and they're like, my friends are like, who is Cursive? And I played them a few of their songs, and they're just like, okay, like, they were not impressed, but fuck them, they're great. The Ugly Organ is one of my favorite albums ever. The cello, the heavy, like, just like the heavy tones in it. It's just so good. Didn't we already do this one? Maybe. Oh, you mean the stream? Yeah, I tried to do it, but didn't work. So it's back, bigger and better than ever. I say better, but the bitrate's all shitty, so that'll be fixed by the next time. So yeah, let's hop in to The Recluse. Because actually, I don't think, as much as I've been blowing smoke up this song's ass, I don't think I've played this song on stream before, which is a goddamn crime. Let's give it a listen. If you haven't heard of Cursive or this song, hopefully this is a good first impression. Here we go. This is Cursive with The Recluse.
I can hardly get myself out of the bed for fear of never lying in this bed again. Oh Christ, I'm not that desperate. Oh no, oh God. And what I feed it, but maybe I don't wanna finish anything anymore. Maybe I can wait in bed till she comes home and whispers,
you're in my world now.
I've come to wrap you up tight till it's time to bite down.
And that was Cursive with The Recluse. Okay, I'm vibing. Glad to hear it. Sam, never heard this before, but I like it. Good pop punk vibes. Cursive was actually a sort of hardcore punkish band up until this specific album where they introduced cello. They didn't use it again till later on, but this album is their first kind of divergence from that to just straight up like normal alternative-ish stuff with still some punky vibes in the background. I love this album. I think it's one of my favorites of all time. And if you like that song, I cannot recommend it enough. It is seriously an amazing album. Happy Hollow, their follow-up to this, are both fantastic. Happy Hollow, I think you might enjoy a bit more if you like the pop-punk, because that has a bit more pop-punk vibe to it, I'd say, than this one. It's almost like ska at some points, but isn't, which pleases me. Yeah, I'm not a big ska guy, so I don't think I'd enjoy it as much if it was just straight-up ska. Dangerously close. Yeah, the last song on that album is one of my favorite final songs. That's the word. It's one of my favorite closers of all time. I love it. I saw Cursive live in college, like I said, and I was in the front just, like, singing my little heart out, just going like, yeah, I love this! And the lead singer saw me, because I was right in front of his fucking face the whole time, and at the end of the concert, he got on one knee, looked me right in the eyes, and shook my hand, and walked off stage. And I will never forget that, because that fucking ruled. I loved he just acknowledging, you're my fan, and I appreciate that. Like, I loved that little moment. Fucking love that guy. All right. Coming up next is Dive with How Long Have You Known. I played Dive a bit earlier on the stream. That first song is my favorite of theirs. And I put this on here because my ex really loved that one song. And I was like, fuck it, I'll put this song on here. She might like it. And I think she did. I don't think she was against it. And like I said, I saw them live. I saw them open for Wild Nothing. And I met them at their booth when I got one of their shirts, which is now hilariously small on me. Like, comically. I love... they're very nice people. I talked to them, and then they're decent. I don't remember exactly what it was, but I said something stupid, and the guy looked at me like, what? And then he just brushed past it and moved on and kept talking to me. And that shows that he's a good guy. That he could have been like, what the fuck are you talking about? But he was like, ah, whatever. Loved it. That's so good. Dive, most recent album, Deceiver, is nuts to be honest, super good. I have only ever heard Ocean before. For some whatever reason, I just dropped Dive after this album. I can't explain why. I need to check them out again, because I did really enjoy this album a lot back in college. Let's do it. I miss going to a merch booth and shit-talking with band members. I know. It's really hard, though. I remember one of the last times I did it is when I saw Acid Mother's Temple, which are a very, like, it's a Japanese band made of a lot of older members, and they were not very proficient in English. So while they were happy to see everyone, they were just like, I don't know what you're saying. And I was like, I'm sorry, I'll move along. But I've had a lot of really good, really good memories of talking to artists after concerts. The venue definitely helps, because there are some bands, there are some venues that, like, that just doesn't happen. But there are some venues where, like you said, Tiny Jars, they are the ones selling their own merch, and it is the best. And I miss that too so much. I cannot wait for this to happen again. I cannot wait for them to come back for that to be a thing. But yeah, I guess let's relive those fond memories in our heads while we listen. Oh wait, no, I miss trying to sell merch. That's sad, Theo. Let's all be sad together, listening to Dive with How Long Have You Known.
Thank you.
And that was Dive with How Long Have You Known. Theo says, some venues try to kick the bands out right after the last set is done, and that's super unfortunate. That is unfortunate. I guess I've never noticed that in DC. I guess all the venues where, in DC anywhere, all the venues that I've been to, that I frequent, where the bands sell their own merch at the back tables, they all, double as bars or something else, so it's never really, we want you out of here so we can close the situation. They're open anyway, so I guess that would make sense for them to kick them out. That's a bummer, though. I don't understand that. Fuck venues that do that. That sucks. Not long before gigs stopped happening, I remember Lightning Bolt were here, and I asked Brian Chippendale to sign a comic of his for me, and he was so nice. That shit's always great. It's always nerve-wracking, because there's the phrase, never meet your heroes, right? So it's always nerve-wracking to go up to someone that you really like and be like, please, I just want to interact with you, please don't be mean. And it's always the best when they're not, because it makes you feel good. It makes you feel like you enjoying their stuff was worth it. I don't think I've ever had a bad interaction at a concert. I don't think. With one of the people there. I've had disappointing interactions, i.e. a lack of interactions, where I thought I'd be able to meet someone and I couldn't. But that's about the extent of it. I've never once, talked to someone after the show and be like, oh, this person fucking sucks. They've always been super nice. And I count myself lucky. Or, maybe, I count myself to be smart and I don't like fans of people who are cool. Hell yeah. Yeah, I was so nervous. Blizzard's for being so kind. I agree. It's great. I love music, and I love musicians, baby. I love musicians. That was my cool accent. Hope you enjoyed it. Coming up next is the radio department with memory loss. Now, I talked about how in the last mix, Heaven's on Fire was my ex and all my friends' favorite radio department song, and really the only song that they really wanted to listen to from them. But you know me, love radio department. I can't let shit go, so I added this song onto the mix. This was a mistake. Not that this song is bad. I love the song. I don't think that she even hated this song. Oh, you want me to do the cool accent again? Hey, listen, I got the cool accent. The radio department with memory loss. This is my cool accent. There are a lot of songs that I like from them that I might not like as much as this song, but are still really good, that are less sad and down-tempo that I could have put on the mixtape, that I should have put on the mixtape. So that was my mistake. Let's get into the song. This is the radio department with memory loss. I hope you enjoy it. Buen provecho. I fucked it up.
Thank you.
And that was The Radio Department with Memory Loss. While I still think that putting that song on that mixtape was a mistake, I do love that song in an immense way. So I'm glad I got to hear it again today. I don't know what the accent that was, but I love it. Yeah, going into it, I didn't think it was supposed to be a New York, like, Italian sort of accent, but that's what it sort of became, and I stuck with it. All right, coming up next is Mew with An Envoy to the Open Fields. So, interestingly enough, this was not the original song that was on the mixtape. I remember this vividly. Originally, I had the Smiths' There Is a Light That Will Never Go Out, or that There Is Light That Never Goes Out on here, during right here. And she hated it. She was like, please make me another mixtape with a different song, because I do not like this song. It scares me, because it's basically talking, she's like, I'm like, why? There's a line where, like, they're talking about crashing a car and dying, and I'm like, oh, okay, fair enough. So I changed it, and I switched to this one. Like, I love Mew, and I know she knew I loved Mew, but she had heard all of the other songs a million times, so I put this song on here, which is a song that I love, but I don't really sort of play as often as I should to other people, and it's one of their best songs, in my opinion, so I put it on here for her, and I think she enjoyed it, because it's a good song. Yeah, you're learning a lot about me and how bumbling I am as a college student. But yeah, this is Mew with An Envoy to the Open Field.
Thank you.
that was Mew with an Envoy to the Open Fields. God damn, do I love Mew. I don't think they will ever not be my favorite band of all time. Like, even if they start releasing albums that fucking suck, they've released enough stuff that I love with, like, the depth of my soul that I think they will forever be my number one. Bless, that's very sweet, I think, to be like, oh, the song is scary. Yeah, she had a lot of moments like that. She was a very... I say this in a very nice, kind way. She's a very ditzy person and a very innocent person in a lot of ways. And I thought that was... It was very charming. And I think that was what drew me to her to begin with. But now... I forgot to mention this. But now, she's engaged to be wed. As of, like, a few days ago. If you can believe it. I've been planning on doing the stream for, like, a month. What are the odds of that happening? It's crazy. But yeah, I wanted to mention a story real quick of when I was in college. This happened right, like, a day or two after me and her started going out, but it doesn't really have anything to do with that. So I don't know why I mentioned it, but I was in my college cafeteria with her and a couple of her friends, and I went on my own to go get, just made myself a PB&J sandwich. I was craving that, you know? And so I'm sitting there, or I'm standing at the sandwich station, just waiting behind someone who is sort of taking their time, like, sort of being slow. I don't really mind. They don't really notice I'm there. I'm not really, like, in a rush, so I don't really tell them to get out of the way or make my presence known. It doesn't matter to me. She's done. She gets her sandwich. She turns around to see me, and she says, "Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't know you were here. I would have moved. I'm so sorry." And a normal person would have responded to that by saying something like, "Oh, it's fine. No worries." Or, "Don't worry about it. It's fine." Or, "Hey, all good." What I said was, "Sandwiches, sandwiches." And then she looked at me with a look I'll never forget. And she left. And I, went back to my table, told all my friends that story, and they all justifiably laughed at me. And they still bring it up to this day. It's such a weird feeling when exes are married or having kids and stuff. It's always like, oh, damn, no, I'm not doing that. Yeah, my high school girlfriend got married to a dude I think she met when she was in graduate school. And, oh boy, is he way more for her than I ever was. I am so happy for her. Like, holy shit. We were never a good match. It was never going to work out in the long run. That was a very much a high school relationship. So I'm very glad she found someone that matched with her. I don't know much about the person that the stream is sort of about. I don't know much about the guy that she's marrying, but she seems very happy. So more power to her. I'm happy for her. Yeah, it's crazy. Thankfully, none of my friends or none of my exes have started having kids yet. That would be insane to me to see that. I don't even want to know what the thought process of that would be for me once it happens. Like, fuck, that could have been my kid, kind of shit. That sucks. We're almost at the end of the stream here. This is the second to last song, and this is Wild Nothing with Chinatown. Now, I played Wild Nothing earlier in the stream. On the first mix with Through the Grass. She liked that album a lot more than she liked this one. But I love this one. This specific mix was a lot of, "You liked that song? Well, you'll love this song." And she didn't really seem to love them. She didn't hate them, but I don't think she was super enthused with this mix as a whole. Didn't help with that Smith song, for sure. But yeah, I love Wild Nothing. Again, following up with that story about Dive, I literally bumped into Wild Nothing. Like, I bumped into the dude on the stairs going down from the merch table to the exit. We talked for a solid 5 minutes. Awesome fucking rad-ass dude. Loved him. I have an ex-GF that's married to a guy after she dated me, and that's like, bless, I'm happy for her. But still, you're feeling yes. Like, none of my exes I have any sort of, like, lingering feelings for at all. So I don't really, I'm not ever like, oh man, they got married, or getting, like, I don't have that feeling. Like, I'm always happy for them, except for my last girlfriend. I've left on good terms with all of my girlfriends, except for my last one, who I honestly don't know much about currently. Like, I have no idea what she's up to, and I'm better off for it. But the other three, that other girlfriends I've had, I know what they're up to. I keep up with them occasionally. We chat every once in a while just to see, and they're all doing fine. And I'm happy for that. I'm very happy for them. And it's a good feeling. But yeah, like I said, it is weird. It is a weird feeling, but it's also a good feeling. Like I can't. It's also weird. Like my first girlfriend, I think she only ever dated me and that guy. And it's weird to me because was I ever brought up to that guy? Like, am I someone that, like, they joke about? Like, oh, your first boy. Like, is that, it's weird, you know? My third girlfriend, I was the first boyfriend she ever had. Her first, like, long-term boyfriend. Am I ever brought, like, it's one of those feelings where it's like, do people talk about me? Why would they? Why do I think that? It's all these weird thoughts, you know? But yeah, it's something I don't think about too often. But whenever I see them, thoughts like that sometimes come up. But yeah. Not all the time. But yeah, let's fuck off with all that bullshit. This is Wild Nothing. This is the second to last song on the stream, Wild Nothing with Chinatown. That was Wild Nothing with Chinatown. Yeah, I love that song. I think it's very good. I remember hearing that song on the metro, listening to the song from my first big fight with my high school girlfriend, my first upper girlfriend. I was on the metro listening to it in D.C., and we were talking about some dumb bullshit that doesn't matter. It was some of the dumb, I don't remember what it was, but I remember looking back on it like at some point thinking that was a dumb argument, but this song was like, we're gonna fight, and this song was the perfect backdrop for that. We're on the last song, if you can believe it. To everyone who has been watching, I appreciate you. Thank you so much. I love you. I respect you. And honestly, deep down in my heart, I need you. Just so you know, I have a link down below the stream that if you missed this, I will be uploading the stream onto YouTube, because Twitch has that thing where it just mutes all of the audio. So the VODs on Twitch aren't really worth having up. I still have them up, but they aren't really worth it. But on YouTube, I upload these radio streams I do. So if you've missed any, or you miss the stream and you just want to go back and maybe listen to any songs you missed for whatever reason, they're there. I try to upload them the night of, and they're usually up by the morning of the next day or whatever. But yeah, I have a decent backlog. I also I pick and choose other various streams that I thought were good, and I'll upload those. So it's not every stream I do, but ones that I like, I upload onto there. So yeah, I have a few of them on there, I think from back of late January, early February is when I started really doing that. So I have about six or seven of these radio streams on there. So yeah, give them a listen if you want. Give them a subscribe, comment if you so choose. Yeah, I appreciate it. If you don't, also, it's also fine. You don't got to do it. It's fine. It's all up to you. So yes, the last song on the stream and for my mixtapes was The National with Exile Vilify. I have already played Lemon World on here, which is already a bummer of a song, which I really shouldn't have put on these mixtapes. She loved it, but I really shouldn't have put it on here. The National is a band that I loved and has become a band I've noticed that I don't enjoy as much anymore. They have a couple. What's it called? High Violet is still one of the all-time greatest albums ever, but most of their albums after that I never really gelled with, and I only like at this point a few of their songs from their albums before that. So that to me wasn't really they're a band that I used to love, and now I'm like I like them. I love High Violet, but I like The National as a whole. Exile Vilify, on the other hand, is a fantastic song, and of course, as a geek and gamer, I had to put on this song from Portal. It's funny because I already was a fan of The National in high school. So when Portal 2 came out when I was a freshman in college, and they did that song, they did the song for it, I was ecstatic because this song fucking rules. This song is so good. And this is also a mistake. I shouldn't have put it on the mixtape. This is such a bummer ass song. It's a beautiful song that I love. I love, love this song, but it's so sad-sounding. It's also an awful closer for a mixtape, too. If for a romantic one, fuck me, what was I thinking? Tiny Jar says, The National was the first band I ever saw live. That fucking rules. I wish I saw them live. I never have. And honestly, at this point, I don't think I ever want to, because the songs that I love, I doubt they'll play. You know? At this point, I feel like they have so many songs that they've released after High Violet, after their earlier stuff, that they'll probably play mostly those at this point, I would think. So I'm good. yes, for all the geeks and gamers, though, yes. The song is for all the geeks and gamers. The cake is a lie. That's how you spot them. let's listen to it. This is the last song of the stream. This is The National with Exile Vilify.
It takes your mind again. Exile. It takes your mind again. You got sucker's luck. Thank you. fast, you're like marbles on glass. Little fast.
And that was The National with Exile Vilify. Thank you so much for watching. Tyshar says, I saw them underage after the Boxer came out and I snuck in. Ooh, naughty. Not a bad first gig. St. Vincent was the supporting act. That's a solid, that is a solid first concert. My first concert. Decidedly less so. I really wanted to see Muse, M-U-S-E, not M-E-W, which is my, Muse was my current favorite band. Muse was my favorite band back when I was way younger, like in middle school through high school. And I missed them, because I had to go to a friend's birthday party. That was a fucking mistake. I should have seen Muse instead. Like, looking back, I don't give a fuck about that guy now, and I still listen to all the Muse albums I liked back then. So that was the wrong choice. But Muse came back to town as an opener. I was like, fuck it, I'll go. They were opening for My Bloody Valentine, who I do not like. Even back then as a kid, I was not a big My Bloody Valentine fan, like, at all. Like, I actively disliked them. And the worst part of it was, live, they were awful. Like, that guy could not sing. Maybe he's better now, but it was awful. And so I saw Muse. They were fantastic. They had a pretty long opening set, too. Like, from what I remember, because Muse was, even back then, like, super, super, like, they were huge in the UK and in Europe in general, I think, back in the day. And My Bloody Valentine opened for them. And so it was like a return the favor sort of thing. Did I say My Bloody Valentine? I'm sorry. Not My Bloody. My Bloody Valentine fucking rules. I'm so sorry. Oh, I'm dumb. I'm so stupid. No. Let me retry this. My Bloody Valentine fucking rules. My Chemical Romance is what I meant. My Bloody Valentine is great. I love them. I'm so sorry that I made that mistake just now. My Bloody Valentine is one of my favorites of all time. I love them. My Chemical Romance sucks. They sucked back then, and they suck now, from what I know. I was like, they're Irish? What? And then I was like, oh, I made a mistake. That's not the initials for the band I'm talking about. Yeah. My Bloody Valentine fucking rules. But Loveless is one of the best albums of all time. Like, no, like, fucking no question. But, Muse is huge in the UK now, I'm guessing, but they were huge back in the day as well. And so when they did the European tour, My Chemical Romance opened for them. And, to return the favor, Muse opened for My Chemical Romance. And Muse was fantastic, and My Chemical Romance was garbage, awful. Like, we paid so much money for that ticket, we left, like, 3 songs into My Chemical Romance because we couldn't handle it anymore. It was awful. Getting your mind up. Yeah, you're laughing at me. That's a mistake I make all the time. In fact, I remember not wanting to listen to My Bloody Valentine when I was younger because I thought they were a similar band to My Chemical Romance. That's how dumb I was. That's how much of a dumbass idiot I was, and still might be to this day. But yeah, I learned my lesson. I love My Bloody Valentine now. This is what I looked like back then. This is my dumbass face back when I was a kid. Look at this fucking idiot. Dumbass mushroom bitch. But yes, thank you guys so much for watching. It means a lot. Like I said, the link to the archive channel is below. I have a bunch of different links down there. Click them if you want. Don't click them if you don't. I respect your decision either way. Just know that whoever you are, wherever you're from, I love you. I respect you. And I appreciate your viewership. It means a lot. And this stream went on a long time today. Over 3 hours is a bit usually not what I like to do. But I haven't streamed in a while, so I was really enjoying talking to y'all. You know, it's fun. It's really fun. I'm going back to I'm going to visit my parents this weekend, so I'm not going to be streaming tomorrow. But I will be back. I'm going to try to stream again Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday. I might do multiple days. I might do one day, I don't know, but I'll be back around then. I also might be back for Leo's stream if he streams on Sunday, which he probably will. I'll see what I do. But yes, bless you as well. Love you guys. Peace out. You have a good night or good day or whatever time it is where you're from. Have a good one. Goodbye.